Orbit maneuvers will start now. So what is this actually technically, if you were to understand this?
When we are in an orbit today, about 245 kilometer by 23,500 apogee,
yeah,
and 245 kilometer perigee.
Right.
We will be firing in the satellite, there is a propulsion system,
right,
with an engine which generates 400 newtons thrust.
Okay.
Then in the final phase, after four orbits in that phase, we will again fire the engine when it is at perigee, which will give a delta velocity, which will make the satellite escape Earth's gravity and travel towards Mars. So the 400 newton thruster, what we have, engine, which is fed with the bipropellants, two propellants, has to fire very accurately. Then once this phase is over, as I told earlier, third phase begins, and once it escapes Earth's gravity, it will keep on traveling next 10 months till it reaches the gravity field of the Mars.
Okay.
At that time exactly we have to reduce the velocity of the satellite by about roughly 1.1 kilometer per second.
Right.
And that firing makes it again to get into orbit around the Mars.
Okay.
That is also should be done precisely.
Right.
The moment it leaves Earth's gravity field and traveling in the interplanetary space, there will be radiation from the heavy particles which are coming from the sun. So this radiation also it has to withstand. And our main aim is to demonstrate and make sure we have technology and engineering capabilities to design a satellite, launch it, and make sure of the mission design and reach it into Mars orbit. That is our primary aim. Once it reaches the Mars orbit, then our experiments will start collecting the data.
That was Dr. M.Y.S. Prasad explaining to us the challenges ahead with this Mars orbiter. Asha Khanam, DD News, Sriharikota.